See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 of them are died, but the other are missing.
A year ago, on November 8, 2013, Dolor Lingo lost 13 members of her family.
At first, it was very painful, but slowly I've come to accept what has happened as the will of God.
Among those who died that day were three of her children, who drowned when tsunami-like waves swallowed up her home.
And the only child to survive?
The only child to survive is here. This one.
This past Saturday, marking the one-year anniversary, Dolor, her husband, and 13-year-old son visited this makeshift grave that holds her children and six other relatives.
I can just imagine them being happy in the presence of God.
12 months on, the Lingos have almost rebuilt their home. Dolor is busy with her children's ministry outreach.
We have a children's feeding program and a ministry to at-risk youth.
Her husband, Dante, is busy leading a small church in the neighborhood.
Even though what happened to us is so painful, I know that in everything, God has a purpose for our lives.
And 13-year-old Dante Jr. has been playing drums in church.
For me, playing the drums lifts my spirit. Even though I lost my brothers and sister, I want to keep on playing.
The Lingos firmly believe that God is using the tragic death of their three children to point people in this neighborhood to Jesus Christ.
Most of our neighbors were unbelievers, but since the death of our children and the example that we've tried to be in the community, now many have become Christians and are attending our church.
The Lingos say they have a special burden for youth in their neighborhood.
A lot of the young kids sniffed glue and some of them gambled. We started reaching out and inviting them to church. At first they didn't want to come, but that has slowly changed.
The Lingos' testimony has reverberated throughout the community.
Before the typhoon, all the young people you see seated in the front row were unbelievers, but after the typhoon, the pastor encouraged us to serve and trust God. We did now. We are telling others about Christ. After the storm, I thought there was nothing left in life. Everything was destroyed. But then the pastor helped me realize that material things are not important. I'm happy that I'm here serving God.
Dante Jr. says he's tried to reach out to the other kids in the neighborhood, but finds it very difficult since he still misses playing with his siblings. He said he's studying hard in school and dreams of being a sailor one day. But for now, his heart is right here behind the drums.
I know God has a purpose for me because he spared my life.
It is a theme that runs through this precious family, devastated by unspeakable loss, yet determined to turn tragedy around for the glory and honor of God.
No matter what storms may come, calamity or tragedy, we must do our best to stand on our feet again and to keep our faith in God. No matter what happens, God is always there.
George Thomas, CBN News, Tacloban, Philippines.